And then a tab. Set up dependencies, just gconf. All the dependencies for that, so let's save link as. Okay, it's capital GC. And right, Orbit is not installed, so we can just copy and paste this. And install it with these commands, and that's done. So that's chapter 33, gconf near the top. Go back to Thunderbird, and that looks like all the dependencies are built, so let's start this downloading, get the patch, and once again while it's downloading I'll copy. Oh, right, there's a note here saying Thunderbird can use 8GB plus of RAM when linking. Make sure you have adequate swap or RAM. So I've got 8GB of RAM. Got 8GB of swap and it's active, so it should be okay. Might get a bit slow at that point, but at least we've got adequate space. So once again, we've got this moz config, and it is the same name as the Firefox one. So it's worth bearing in mind if you do keep a copy outside of the Thunderbird directory. So once again, I'm going to rename this so you can see that one says Firefox. I'll rename this one to Thunderbird, because they are different. .0.3, and then I'll edit that. And just read the options again. So if you installed wireless tools, comment this line. So we have installed it. So we want to comment that out. Uncomment if you've not installed Pulse Audio, we have. And uncomment this if you installed AlsaLib instead of, so we haven't installed it instead of that. Comment out the following options if you've not installed recommended dependencies, we have. So it seemed like the Firefox built okay, so I would assume we can comment that out. And again, not to change anything below that line there, so we'll save that. The download is finished, so let's extract Thunderbird. Okay, that's expanded, so now I'm going to go into it and then take a copy of the moz config for Thunderbird and just call it moz config. And then we should be able to now run this patch. And then I'll run this up to the configure just to make sure the configure is okay, and then I'll start the build. Okay, that's done. So now I'll be able to run the build. And again, this will take several hours. Okay, so that has finished compiling. Like Firefox, it's taken just about 2 hours, 10 minutes. This one, there's no test suite to run that's mentioned. So I'll just go straight for the install. And just delete the environment settings, environment variables that were set above. And that should be it. There's some configuration information there. And some information for desktop environments. So add that in. And that's done. I'll just see how big this one is as well. Okay, it's about half the size of Firefox. So Thunderbird is complete. I'll mark that one off. And I'll quickly do a test run of it. I'm not going to set it up or anything. There's the frame. Right, it's decided to create a frame that's bigger than the actual display screen, so I need to shrink it down a bit. Oh, okay, it's not that bad actually. So yeah, it seems to have started up okay at least. So like I said, I'm not going to set it up at all. I guess I could put some rubbish in here. So this is probably going to fail whatever I do here, so if I just do cancel and finish, there you can see the actual main interface, so that all looks good. I don't want to do that, and create a new message there, there's a pop-up window and so on. So I'll just, as before, check the formatting works. Yep, that seems to be fine. And select certain fonts as well. Okay, so that's all complete. Discard changes. I'll delete this as well. I'm not sure how to delete this actually. Okay, that's something I'll have to leave for another time. So I presume Control Q works out. Yes, it does. So that's Thunderbird complete.